And first of all, the president will be upset if we didn't say to you, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you as well.
Appreciate it. So, Sheriff, what do you make of the fact that that the president has been invited? He's going to speak at the Civil Rights Museum, John, and we've got very famous civil rights, what would you call them? Icons. Mm-hmm. That have decided not to be there. What do you think of that boycott?
John, who?
John Lewis. John Lewis, he was bloodied on the Selma Bridge, Sheriff, when he was trying to protest voting rights and organizing sit-ins
and Lewis,
a variety
and
of things
Lewis
on behalf
become,
of the black community.
Are you going to let me talk, Eboni?
Oh, well,
John
sir,
Lewis,
you, I was just addressing
you
your question.
Talk,
you asked who, so I was telling you about, a bit about John Lewis.
You didn't let me finish. John Lewis has become one of the most irrelevant members of Congress. Have you taken, Eboni, a look at his congressional district, the high poverty, the high unemployment, the crime that goes on, the failing schools that have gone on in his district under his leadership? Look, nobody cares what John Lewis is doing. He's been reduced to being a caricature in that he has to pull a political stunt like this. He can't even honor the Civil Rights Museum opening. He has to pull a political stunt to get news coverage. That's how bad this is. Look, Donald Trump realizes that he's the president of all people. He also realizes that actions speak louder than words. So his showing up, I think, signals, and what these obstinate people are afraid of, that President Donald Trump is winning hearts and minds quietly and slowly throughout black America, as they are willing to give him a chance, as he asked during the campaign. So I think the event will be better off without those people there.
Well, Sheriff, let me say this to you. For you to say that nobody cares about John Lewis is inaccurate, because I assure you that there are many people across this country that absolutely do care about him. As for your commentary on his political record as a congressman, I'm actually not even addressing that part, because this museum opening is about the civil rights of American citizens. So when it comes to his record on that, Sheriff Clarke, I think it's pretty undisputed.
All right, well, let me say this to you, Eboni, that if you went into any black high school and probably most black colleges in America and talked to black people under the age of 35, they would not know who John Lewis is. I'm not trying to diminish what he did, all right, but I'm talking about today.
I'm talking about today.
What he did was a political stunt. I think it's a slap in the face. And keep this in mind, too, Eboni, that if it weren't for the Republicans in Congress in the 1960s, there would be no Civil Rights Act. There would be no Voting Rights Act, as Lyndon Johnson, the Democrat president, had to use Republicans. He had to rally Republicans in order to pass the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act, because the Democrats in Congress opposed it.
No, here's the thing, though, Sheriff. I appreciate that history lesson, but as somebody that holds a degree on the subject, I really don't need you to update me on who was required for Lyndon B. Johnson to pass the Civil Rights Act.
Apparently, you've forgotten some of your history.
I absolutely don't have anything against Republicans. It's
amazing.
Would
we not be talking about? I wouldn't know that this Civil Rights Museum is being opened up if this president had not agreed to accept an invitation to speech. Isn't he not shining a light on a very important museum as well?
Exactly. He adds to the moment, and he's being responsible in doing so. Look, Donald Trump could care less about whether any of these people are showing up or what they think. He's going to do what's in the best interest of all Americans. And the right thing to do, the best thing to do, is to show up at this opening and just kind of ignore the fact that some people have chosen this to use as a platform to make a political statement.
Okay, Sheriff, I got something that maybe you and Eboni will agree upon, and that is President Trump talking about keeping us safe. Take a listen.
We're going to have safety, and we've got a lot more now. We're getting rid of the MS-13 animals. We're going to have safety again. Because America is more than just a place on a map. America is a nation. America is a family. America is ours to love and to cherish and to protect and to take care of, and that's what we're doing. We're going to take care of this country for our children and our grandchildren and our great-grandchildren, and we're not going to let people come into our country who are going to destroy our country.
Sheriff, what's your reaction to those comments?
Well, look, it was a hallmark of his campaign, law and order, the rule of law. MS-13 has been allowed to go on in this country and exist for several decades. They've been around since the 1980s. Everyone ignored them, and now it's a huge problem. But it is going to be taken care of by President Trump through the United States Department of Justice, who are lending their resources to the local law enforcement. They have more teeth with the federal code. They can provide money for some of the overtime to take the burden off some of the local budgets to get this done. But he is going to rid this country of this evil gang, this very violent and vicious gang, MS-13.
Yep, that's certainly what they are. Sheriff David, David Clarke.
Don't forget to click subscribe. It's almost as satisfying as skip ad.